What is going on, everybody? Estas here. Good morning. Welcome back to another video. So in today's video, we're going to be talking about very quickly a couple of stocks and ETFs that I'm personally looking to trade here this morning on the 21st of March in 2019. But before we talk about these, let's hop here to the Safari tab very quickly and see what the U.S. stock market futures are doing right now. So the S&P currently with about 30 minutes left to the market open, to the bell, is down about $9.25, down about 0.33%. The NASDAQ composite, guys, is also red here, down about $28.75, down about 0.4%. And the Dow Jones Industrial Average is down $82 right now, down nearly 0.32% on the day. So the futures right now are pointing to us opening red here and potentially selling off further. So let's hop over here to Thinkorswim very quickly. And before we talk about Facebook, let's look at this SPX chart. So we saw the futures are down for the S&P 500. They're down about 8 to 10 points right now. So what is that going to look like here at the market open? Well, you can see this little trend line that I drew out here for you guys. It's going to look something similar like that, right? If we do end up opening up at these levels where we're down about 8 to 9 to 10 points in the SPX, we're going to be trending below this support here, which was a resistance. We broke above it, held it as a new support for a couple of days here. And now if we open up down 10 points, we're going to end up trending below that. And that could be the start of the sell-off here, that retracement in the overall markets that we've been talking about here over the past couple of videos. And if you guys don't recall what I'm saying here, well, over the past couple of months in 2019, the markets have been on fire. And every time we've pushed to a higher high, we've seen a flat line and then a little retracement, whether it be 1 to 3%. This last one that we got here was about 3%, right? We saw the flat line, then the pullback. And now we saw the flat line a couple of days ago. Maybe today we flatline as well. It's not a 100% guarantee that we're going to sell off aggressively today. But let's say we flatline again today. You know, what I'm going to be looking for is that start of a sell-off, the break below this support. But again, if the futures do open up down 10 points, or if the markets do open up down 10 points, 15 points, whatever, we're already going to be heading in that direction, which is going to lead me to believe that today is going to be that sell-off day. So that is just to clear things up in the air right now, guys, with what the markets are looking like overall here. Now let's just hop back to Facebook, which is one of the stocks that I'm watching today for a potential trade. So Facebook, ticker symbol FB, this has been in the news a lot over the past couple of weeks here. We all know the executives leaving, Instagram executives leaving, WhatsApp people leaving, a lot of news coverage for Facebook, right? The data, you know, the New Zealand massacre being live streamed throughout a bunch of social media sites. You know, this is something that Facebook has been dealing with heads on here. And the stock price has taken a hit from 172 at this resistance a couple of weeks ago, really about a week or two ago, all the way down to about 158 to 159, where we successfully held the support here on this horizontal channel. And yesterday we saw us pop up to about $165, which leads me to believe that the confirmation, or rather the support, was confirmed here, and we're headed back up to that $170 resistance. So Facebook is one I'm watching here to see, are we going to potentially pull back, which it does seem like we're looking like we are here pre-market hours. If we pull back to about 164 flat maybe, or rather, you know, 164.50, 164, maybe even 163.50, that could open up a nice little dip buy so we can get in at a better point and then ride it up to the resistance at this point, which is going to be the 50 SMA. And then if we break that, you know, the 170 will be the next price target, or actually about 168 right here would be the next price target. and then up to about 170. And I apologize, guys. I do have a little bit of a runny nose right now, but I still have to get this video out for you guys, and I do want to tell you guys what I'm looking at this morning. So Facebook, that is what I'm looking at, one of the stocks. Another one that's forming a very similar pattern as yesterday is crude oil here, and it might be a bit too late right now to hop in, and by the time, you know, the markets do open, this one might be running up already, so I'd be waiting for another pullback. But like I said in yesterday's morning's video, I talked about how we sold off, and this is a very similar thing that happened yesterday. Remember, we sold off yesterday, heading to the market open roughly, and then we started to pop up, heading into the market open, and that's where I ended up hopping into UWT in yesterday's morning, right? And now we're seeing something very similar. We're selling off, and now we're starting to fly up past the resistance points over the past couple of hours, which was the 50 and the 180 simple moving averages. So the fact that we're showing this reversal gives me, honestly, the confirmation that we're heading back up to about $60.30. So ideally here, I would love to see a little pullback before market open so we can get into UWT, which is the bull ETF here that trades based upon crude oil. Whenever crude oil is going up, UWT is going up as well. So that's one I'm watching in terms of ETFs here. Natural gas is finally looking, it's finally looking like we're headed into the 270s right now, which is a very good sign to play DGAS, guys. DGAS is a bear ETF. It goes up in price whenever natural gas is selling off. So we know here, let me just quickly erase all of this noise here. Let me quickly clear this drawing set so we can get a clearer understanding of what's going on. So we talked about over the past couple of videos how natural gas has been in this horizontal pattern, and we confirmed the resistance rejection here back on the 19th of March, 2 days ago, and from there, we've been trending down to about 280 right now. So what am I going to be waiting for the full-on confirmation to play DGAS? Well, I'm going to be waiting for the break below 277. This has been a support over the past couple of weeks, starting off on the 26th of February, back during this stretch of a couple of days here from the 11th to the 13th of March. Back here on the 18th of March, we confirmed the bounce. And now I'm thinking we're going to be headed to this level either for a break below, which would be a bearish move, or we're going to bounce here and slowly start to fill up to the resistance of this horizontal pattern in order to keep this horizontal pattern intact. So there's a couple of different things here, but I do think eventually we're going to end up falling down below this level, because this time period we're in right now, typically DGAS does better, right? In the winter, you know, natural gas is bullish, but now that we're getting out of the winter, you know, DGAS tends to do a little bit better, which is why I think we're going to end up running down below this support level. But again, I could be 100% wrong. You have to do your own research. So natural gas, DGAS, that's what I'm watching this morning, as well as UWT and crude oil. Very similar to what I've been watching here over the past couple of trading days, as well as Facebook. Let's take a look very quickly at MU, Micron. This is one that's worth watching, in my opinion, as well. We saw the big hike up yesterday after market hours, after they did report their earnings. Let's take a look at their earnings very quickly. I'm sure there is a little bit of news here. We see some price targets, you know, being raised on Micron, which is very, very good. Stock price raised to $64 from $55 at JP Morgan, $60 from $65. Okay, that was a price cut there. We saw this analyst company, they raised it to $49 from $45. So typically people, people like, investors, traders like when analysts do raise price targets. That is a very good thing. And for those of you guys that don't know about their earnings, I'm trying to find it here, but I don't want to keep this video too long. They did beat on revenue and they did beat on EPS, but I'm pretty sure they guided a bit lower here over the next quarter or two. That's just me subphrasing what I remember off the top of my head. If you want to look more into Micron's earnings report, go ahead and do that research. I'm not going to be talking about that in this video, but I do think it is worth watching here for a potential run especially since the pattern is honestly looking like a nice reversal pattern here to the upside, right? So Micron could end up being a pretty good swing trade here. We just have to see if it ends up breaking $43. This resistance here to go and make a higher high. I think that's very, very possible here in terms of in terms of Micron stock. So let me just really quickly, briefly talk about these marijuana stocks and see if they've made any moves here. CGC, not really any moves here quite yet, pre-market hours. I want to see the break ultimately above $48 in CGC. ACB, Aurora Cannabis, I want to see a further pullback here. But the fact that we're consolidating here in the pre-market hours, that leads me to believe that we could be doing something like this where we consolidated a bit, then popped, consolidated a bit, then popped, consolidated a bit after a little pullback. We could either pop here or sell off a bit more, which is what I want to happen so I can get in. But if we do see signs of popping up here, I might get in early in the market and then ride it with a tight stop loss. We have to see what ends up happening. So that's what I'm watching here. A couple of stocks and ETFs, ACB, CGC, the cannabis companies, of course, they are very, very hot. They can fly up 10% in a day. They can go down 10% in a day. Natural gas, UGAS, DGAS, CL, crude oil, UWT, DWT, Facebook, and TVIX, guys. How can I forget? TVIX, very quickly, this is an ETF that goes up when the markets are selling off. So let's say today we do aggressively sell off in the SPX, the Dow, the NASDAQ. This is going to be one to watch. TVIX does very well during market sell-offs. So I'm watching TVIX, guys, and all of those different stocks and ETFs that I just told you guys about. So I hope you guys enjoyed this morning video. If you did, feel free to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel if you're new, drop a comment, let me know what you guys are trading. I would love to know. Hope you all do very well today. I'll catch you all in the Discord group chat. Again, that's linked down below as well. 100% free. See you there.